Well, so far, June, a very warm month, and as we look ahead to the start of July, we're seeing increasing confidence that it's going to be hot. Like a lot of people, one of the first things you do in the morning is you wake up, maybe you check the weather on your phone. Well, we know some of you did that this morning, and we've heard a lot of people saying, wait a minute, what's it going to be next week? Yeah, some of these phone apps were showing some pretty incredible heat going into next weekend, but we don't want you to focus on that just yet. What we are confident in is that there will be some hot days next week, and it will be a stretch of heat that will come with some kind of uncomfortable nights. But first, let's start off with how we make our forecast and what details you can trust in a forecast at a certain time. So at 10 days out, looking ahead to next weekend, there really isn't much confidence in forecast accuracy. All we can discern is broad patterns, things like, are we going to see a stretch of heat, or are we going to be closer to average? Very broad ideas there. Once we get to within 5 to 7 days, so towards the end of our 7-day forecast, we can start to really sniff out, okay, is it going to be 100 plus, yes or no? And we can start to say that with some confidence, but even there, not as much confidence as what some may like when they're making their plans. Once we get to within 2 to 5 days, that's where we can start looking at potential impacts of something like heat. Is it going to be 100 degrees for maybe 30 minutes to an hour? Or are we talking about several hours of triple digit heat coupled with some very warm mornings? We're somewhere in between here when we're talking about next week's heat as far as just how much we're able to tell you with good accuracy. If you want a specific high temperature, there, meaning is it going to be 104 or 106? We can't really do that with good accuracy until we're about 1 to 2 days out. So the bottom line here is if you're looking at that phone app and you're looking at maybe next Thursday, Independence Day, know that that exact number is going to change a little bit, but the idea is, what we can tell you with some certainty is that Independence Day and the days around it are looking hot. This is why we've got this area of heat building offshore. Last few days, our heat has been focused to the east. We've had access to the Delta breeze that's kept it from getting too hot. But going into next week, this bubble of heat is going to settle pretty much right overhead. At least that's how it looks for right now. That means we lose the Delta breeze, we lose the effect of cooling that it can bring. So that means we can say with some confidence that we're going to be headed into a stretch of heat. We'll be close to 100 degrees in some areas on Monday. Tuesday and Wednesday look like the peak of this heat for the time being. That is going to come with some uncomfortable nights, potentially morning temperatures in the 70s for the valley and closer to 80 degrees into the foothills. There may be some days where we have to watch for a dry north breeze. That's one of those details that, again, we can get more specific with as we get into next week. But just know, again, next week, the first week of July, it's coming in with quite a bit of heat.